Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today we are going to walk you through my first workout post-op. So some of you guys know I had breast augmentation surgery 3 weeks ago and I am now approved to start my lower body workouts. So this is gonna be the first of a couple of videos I'm gonna be doing for you guys to show you how I get back into training and my progression. Hopefully by week six, I'll be approved to do some upper body work as well. And I will show you guys how all that goes for me. So if you like this video and you want to see more content like this, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Appreciate you guys so much. Today, I'm also going to show you my pre-workout meal before we head to the gym, and then I'll walk you guys through the actual workout, what I'm doing for lower body, just to take it light and to also make sure that I am feeling good and my endurance is good. I really don't know what it's going to be like, so stay tuned for more. All right, so first things first, I'm making my coffee. So we are out of eggs because we were traveling last week and didn't go grocery shopping, but I have some chocolate whey. This is the, I'll show you guys. This is the raw nutrition protein powder and chocolates. Actually tastes like a brownie. So I'm actually going to pour this into my coffee and make sort of a protein coffee mocha kind of thing. So. So we'll let that brew, and then my cream of rice is ready. So this is my carbohydrate, doing 60 grams of cream of rice. And that is the perfect texture that I like. And I always salt it. I'm gonna add lots of cinnamon. Mix that up, and then it's like fall, so I'm really into like that kind of fall comfort food right now. So I've got, come take a look at this. I've got what I call banana Fosters. So banana in the air fryer. It's, I just slice it up and toss it in cinnamon and a little bit of sugar-free sweetener. It's, and carries sugar-free sweetener, and then just stick in the air fryer for like 10 minutes and it smells. I wish you guys could smell this. It's so good, but I just kind of throw that on top. So this is going to be, I'm actually going to add a little bit more because we are not in prep right now. So a little bit more of this stuff. It's going to be my, going to be my breakfast. And then coffee is ready. I usually drink my coffee black, but I wanted to get my protein in and I kind of want to just experiment with this today. So in it goes, and I always mix it separately because otherwise it doesn't, if you put the protein out in, you kind of get clumps. So I like to mix it separately and then add it to my coffee. And come take a look at this. It looks like, actually looks and smells kind of like a mocha or like a chocolate milk. So ooh, that's good. That's really good. This is my breakfast. I'm gonna go ahead and eat this right now. I'm gonna get my bag together, take my pre-workout, and head to the gym. All right, guys, so we just got to Fit Club. I'm gonna go ahead and start my workout. I had my breakfast, my pre-workout, and the game plan for today is really just to test the waters and see how things are going. I am 3 weeks post breast augmentation, so I'm approved to do light lower body work. So that's the game plan for today. I'm going to focus on a lot of isolated movements for the glutes, hamstrings, and quads. So pretty much kind of touch up on everything. Starting with about half the weight that I typically would do. And I'm gonna do higher reps just to get blood flow. I'm not going for any PRs or trying to do anything crazy here. We're just trying to get my muscles activated again and really just feel it out and start to build my strength up. I do anticipate that I'll probably be sore after this workout because it has been 3 weeks since I've trained legs. All right, so I'm using the pads here. Sorry. Okay, so we are starting with the hip abduction. We're gonna do 4 sets of 30 here. And again, my focus is gonna be on keeping my upper body and my arms free from touching anything, so I'm not tempted to pull or utilize any upper body muscles at all during this. I'm really focusing on squeezing the glutes and keeping tension in the glutes, even though I'm not going heavier. Halfway, definitely feeling the burn here. All right, guys, so we're gonna move on to hamstring work right now. I typically will do the lying leg curl machine, but in order for me to do that, I'd have to lay down on my stomach, and I'm not supposed to be in that position. And I also don't wanna be bracing my upper body. So as a modification, I'm gonna do the standing leg curl. Now, if you don't have this machine in your gym or you're doing home workouts, you can do a standing leg curl using cables or a loop bands, but I have the single leg machine. The other reason I chose this machine is because I want to do unilateral movements. I am going lighter weight on this, so as a way to continue to challenge my body still, I want to just really isolate and not have both legs working at the same time. So single leg is gonna be the best option for this one. So again, I'm gonna go super, super light on this. And I'm gonna do, I forgot. I'm gonna do 4 sets, 15 reps. And if we can, we're gonna superset that with leg extensions. Felt that. Okay, we're gonna hop onto the leg extension, so work some quads. Again, I'm gonna do single leg on this because I'm gonna go super lightweight. And if I was going heavier, I would have to grab onto the sides here and sort of pull myself into the chair to keep myself down, which is a lot of upper body work. So we don't want any of that at all. So I'm gonna go super light, but I'm gonna focus on one leg at a time to really get that mind to muscle connection and contract and really feel the squeeze and hopefully get a good burn here. We're gonna go for about 12 to 15 reps. Sky in the corner. 9 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 10 Okay. Something else that I'm doing is I'm really minding my tempo here, not rushing the rep. I'm getting a nice solid squeeze at the top and really controlling on the way down. If you do it this way, you don't have to go heavy. You'll definitely feel it when you take all the momentum out. And whew. All right, so I'm gonna do three more rounds just like that, and then we're gonna move on to some cable kickbacks. Okay, we're at the cable machine. I'm gonna do glute kickbacks. I'm gonna do three sets of 15 to 20 on each leg, and I'm not gonna take any breaks at all. I'm just gonna go from leg to leg, back and forth, and just knock it out. Again, I'm not going for PRs here. I'm really just getting blood flow and focusing on squeezing the muscle and really just getting blood flow in that area. I'm gonna do my best to not brace here too much. So I'm gonna go super light just to make sure I don't have to use anything in my upper body at all, and just really try to protect the area that where I had surgery. So as you can see, I just have my hands placed lightly against the pole, the bar, just for balance. I'm not trying to grab onto it or squeeze or anything like that. Obviously, if I was going heavier, I would have to do that. So it's really a lot of focus to make sure that you are avoiding doing anything where you're creating tension in the upper body. That felt pretty good. Definitely got my heart rate up here. 152. All right, so I'm gonna go two more rounds like that, and then we're gonna move on to leg press superset with walking lunges. All right, so we're over here at the leg sled. I got my handy dandy cameraman to load me up with a plate here, but if you're at the gym by yourself, definitely get someone nearby, a friendly face, to get some plates on here for you. Don't do it yourself. And then if this isn't available, I would probably just stick with body weight squats. Maybe put a band on my legs. But since I am at the gym, I do have this available to me. I'm gonna utilize it as best as I can. I'm probably not gonna go much heavier than this. And I'm also gonna stick with unilateral movement still. So again, single leg on this exercise. So on this one, I'm really focusing on lowering down slowly. Again, I mentioned before, the tempo is really important. And getting good pause at the bottom. pushing through my heel. So much of this is mind to muscle connection and really creating tension. It's almost like I'm dragging the plate down with me, not just relaxing. Pause at the bottom and then push through the heel, squeeze right here. And again, my upper body really isn't doing anything here, right? So I'm just trying to keep everything, not grabbing or pulling onto anything. And I'm gonna do 12 reps on each leg, and then I'm gonna superset this with walking lunges. So when you can't go heavy, the way to increase your intensity is to focus on tempo, creating tension in the muscle, and then again, dropping into single leg, single arm movements in the future, single arm, not right now, single leg movements for today will dramatically increase the intensity. One more. Okay. All right, let's do some walking lunges. So to add intensity here, I'm doing a little baby kind of half rep on each leg. Gonna do 10 on each leg. And then a breath. But it doesn't take much when you've been out of it for 3 weeks. Let's see what my heart rate is. 150. All right, so I'm gonna do two more rounds just like that. I'm gonna keep the weight the same on the leg press for today. That kicked my butt. Just take it easy, and then I'm gonna finish off with one more exercise. We're gonna do one more hamstring exercise and some calves, and that'll be it. We'll do both legs and just really focusing on tempo here. I'm gonna flex the feet to come in and then point the toes to come up. Just really focusing on squeezing. Again, if I was going super heavy on this, I mean, I can do, my muscles can do a lot more, but we want to ease back into it, number one. And number two, I don't want to have to brace on anything. Three more. Ooh. Ooh. All right, quick break. Just gonna do about 45, 60 seconds here. I'm gonna do three more rounds like this, and that's gonna be it. All right, so that was a great workout. Felt really good to start moving. Of course, I was tempted to go heavier on some of the exercises, but really just trying to honor my recovery period. Again, I had breast augmentation surgery 3 weeks ago, and really just wanting to make sure that I have the right healing time and not rush it. I have nothing coming up for a while. I won't be prepping for Worlds until the springtime. So this really is the perfect time for me to just allow my body to rest and recover. This workout would absolutely be suitable for somebody who maybe has an upper body injury of any kind, or for some reason doesn't want to do anything upper body wise. So if you guys have any questions on this, feel free to leave a note in the comments or send me a personal note on IG. My Instagram is @sixpackchick. And please remember to like, subscribe, and share this content if you like it. We're gonna be having a series of videos just like this to show you guys my progression over the next several weeks, so you can see some other variations of this lower body workout for you to try on your own.